In this session, we'll be focusing on another question where we will be preparing flexible budget. And the question goes like this. The budgeted expenses for the production of 10,000 units in the factory are furnished below. Prepare the budget for production of 8,000 units. They have given us the cost which is related to manufacturing 10,000 units. And they're expecting us to go about with the preparation. They're expecting us to prepare the flexible budget for 8,000 as well as for 10,000 units. And they've given us the details of some costs. So let's look at the cost one by one. First is material. Material, we know it's a variable cost. Then we have labor. Labor is also a variable cost. Then we have variable overhead. That is also a variable cost. We have fixed overhead, which is 1 lakh. Then we have direct variable overhead, which is 5 rupees. Then we have selling and distribution expenses, which is a semi-variable cost. So that is a semi-variable cost. Then we have administrative expenses, which is 50,000, which is also a fixed cost. So these are the details, and based on these details, we will have to go about with the preparation of the flexible budget. Now let's look at the format of the flexible budget. In this question, we've been asked to prepare for levels of activities of 8,000 units and then 10,000 units. For each of these levels of activity, we would have to estimate the cost per unit as well as the total cost. So let's start one by one. The first item that has been given to us is material cost. And then material cost, we know it is a variable cost. Okay? We know that material cost, this is a variable cost, and variable cost we have calculated. So here, how do we calculate the total cost? It will be 70 into 8,000 units, which is 56. This will be 5,60,000. This will be 5,60,000. Then similarly for 10,000 units, so it will be 70 and then 70 into 10,000, which makes it 7 lakh. The next item that we have is labor. Okay, next item that we have is labor. We know labor is also a variable cost. Here it is 25 into 8,000, which makes it 2 lakh. Similarly for 10,000 units, which makes it 2,50,000. Then we have variable overhead. So as the name itself suggests, it is a variable cost. Okay, as the name itself suggests, it is a variable cost. So here it is 20 rupees. So here, how do we calculate? Here it will be into 8,000, which makes it 1,60,000. Similarly, we will have to calculate for 10,000 units. So rupees 20 into 10,000 units, which makes it 2 lakh. Then you have the fixed. Then you have the fixed overhead. Fixed overhead, we know this is as the name suggests, it is a fixed cost. So what is unique about fixed cost? Unique about fixed cost is that the total cost will remain the same. Okay? The total cost will remain the same. So, cost per unit will vary. Okay? Cost per unit will vary. So here, how do you calculate the cost per unit? This will be 1 lakh divided by 8,000 units, which makes it 12.5. Here, similarly, let's go about with the calculation. So 1 lakh divided by 10,000, which makes it 10 rupees. Okay? Which makes 10. Then you have direct variable overhead. Okay? Direct variable overhead. Direct variable overhead would be 5. Okay? So 5 into 8,000 units, which makes it 40,000. Similarly, for 10,000 units, so here it would be 5 into 10,000 units, which makes it 50,000. Okay? Which makes it 50,000. Next is selling and distribution expenses. Selling and distribution expenses. We know that selling and distribution expenses, this is a semi-variable cost. Now, how do we know it's a semi-variable cost? We know it's a semi-variable cost because if you notice, in bracket, it is mentioned to us as 20% fixed. So what about the remaining 80%? The remaining 80% would be variable. Okay, the remaining 80% would be variable. So it means it is an example of semi-variable cost. So let's go about with the calculation. Okay, let's go about with the calculation. So here, how you would be calculating is, this is rupees 20 per unit. Okay, so this is rupees 20 per unit, and this is for production of 10,000 units. Okay. So this is for production of 10,000 units. Okay. So similarly, we will have to calculate the total cost. We will have to calculate the total cost, and so the total cost will work out to be. Okay, so which means the total cost will work out to be 2 lakhs. Okay, so it is rupees 2 lakhs. Selling and distribution expenses will be 2 lakhs. So it will be 2 lakhs for producing 10,000 units. Now in this, we know that the selling and distribution, it has got two parts. The first part is the fixed component. So fixed component is 20%. Okay? So fixed component is 20%. So 20% of what? It will be 20% of. It will be 20% of 2 lakhs. Okay? So it will be 20% of rupees 2 lakhs. So 20% of rupees 2 lakhs will work out to be. That will work out to be 40,000. So this will work out to be rupees 40,000. Then you have the variable component. So variable component works out to be 80%. Okay, this works out to be 80%. So 80% of what? 80% of rupees. 80% of rupees 2 lakhs. Okay, so this works out to be. This works out to be rupees 1,60,000. Okay, so this works out to be 1,60,000. Now let's calculate the cost per unit. Okay, now let's calculate the cost. Let's calculate the cost per unit. Rupees 1,60,000 divided by 10,000 units. This divided by 10,000 units. So this works out to be rupees 16. Okay, this works out to be rupees 16 per unit. Okay, so this works out to be rupees 60 per unit. So let's just quickly come and substitute over here. Okay, I'm just going to write this as selling and distribution expenses in short. The fixed is at the rate of 20%, and we know fixed means total cost will remain the same. Okay, total cost will remain the same. So total cost here is 40,000. So we have to calculate cost per unit. So how do we calculate cost per unit? 40,000 divided by 8,000, which makes it 5 rupees. Similarly, for 10,000 units, it will be 40,000 divided by 10,000 units, which makes it 4 rupees. Likewise, we also have to calculate for the variable component. So variable component will be 80%. So 80% of this will be 16. So this will be 16 per unit. Okay, and let's just quickly calculate. Oh, that will be 1,28,000. Okay, that will be 1,28,000. And here it will be 1,60,000. So we have done with the selling and distribution expenses. Now we have to calculate the admin expenses. Okay, we have to calculate the admin expenses. We know that the admin expenses, that is a fixed cost. Okay, that is a fixed cost. And fixed cost, remember, total cost will remain the same. Cost per unit will vary. So how do we calculate cost per unit? So here it will be divided by 8,000 units, so which makes it 6.25, and here it will be 50,000 divided by 10,000, which makes it 5. So with that, we have completed the preparation of the flexible budget. Now notice here also, at 8,000 units, it will cost us 159.75, whereas for 10,000 units, it will cost us 155. Okay, so this is again called as economies of scale. So dear students, with that,